at Skater Minnesota, we deal with a lot of different things. Spring, it's rain. Summer, it's humidity. Fall doesn't last long enough. It's way too short. Winter, what can you say about winter? It's cold, there's snow, it's almost unskatable, but instead of sitting at home complaining about it, why not go out and try to make something happen?
Honestly, when I saw it, the first thing that came to my mind was going for that 50-50, not locking in right, and just getting broke off.
I don't know everything about it. Like, you're jumping onto an ice block, man. Like if you miss your board and your foot touches that ledge, you better pray. Like, you think you land your trick perfect, and then the ground's just wet on that masonite, and shoot, out you go, land right on your ass.
And CJ's like, yeah, it's over with. Done, these blocks are done. And Clover just comes up and backside 50-50, just right through it. Within seconds of him saying that.
You never know what you're going to get in the spring. You might get the snow, you might get rain, you might get a gorgeous day. I mean, you can never tell, and it changes every day. We're just so used to not knowing what's coming that it doesn't matter. Whatever we get, we'll deal with it.
It's just still so crappy. There's so much grime, so much salt, so much sand, so many puddles, so many little snow piles, and like so many rocks, man. We need to get that one good rain to get it all out of the way for us. First nice day of spring, all you want to do is go out and skate. So you call into work, I'm not gonna be able to make it in today. Click, out the door, you're skating all day.
I was first person to go in.
Next thing you know, like, all my clothes are soaked, so I gotta hang them up to dry and finally find my board again an hour later and start skating my board and my draws.
After so many boards just getting lost, Chad finally came up with the idea of putting two empty water bottles and masking taping them around your skateboard just so that it would stay afloat when you dropped it in, and it actually worked like a charm. When I was a kid, I used to watch videos of like skate camps that had, you know, like a pontoon set up to a dock, and I was, oh man, that would be so much fun. And now the opportunity actually came out, you know, and we got to do it.
My dad, like, wait, what are you doing this weekend? You're gonna go skateboard in a cornfield?
It's just totally unexpected. You don't, like, drive somewhere to go skate to go into a cornfield and, like, skate such a perfect setup all the time.
Warmed up again, get hyped on the next obstacle, down a couple Red Bulls, and, like, just back in there.
That was the funnest part about it, just running around and be like, oh, we're doing this right now? You're just jazzed up, you're like, yeah, this is it, let's do this.
Everyone was so stoked to be there. So stoked just to do whatever they could on the stuff. And everyone had ideas going through their head what they wanted to do. Everyone brought something different to the table. So everyone fed off of each other, and it ended up being a really cool shoot because the vibe was really good. I think that's kind of with anything in skateboarding. You get the right crew together, you can do anything that's just fun.
The four seasons in Minnesota present a lot of different changes. You can either sit back and complain or get used to it because it's going to happen again the next year.
We'll be right back.